minimum pressure, it draws a thin line. A little bit more pressure and it draws a thicker line. My Yoga 520 came with a free stylus. Other than the pen, it comes with a USB pen holder and a quadruple A battery. Let's first insert the battery. And then the USB pen holder into a USB slot. And insert the pen as such. My first impression, even before I start using it, I don't like it for three reasons. It's huge and heavy compared with its cousin from the Lenovo Helix. It needs a battery to operate, whereas its cousin can run on its own. The USB pen holder is simply ugly and not practical. Its cousin Helix has its own pen slot built in. Oh wait, it's also blocking my power input. To be fair, this pen is designed for the professional artist. The whole body is made of metal, including the clip. It has two quick access side buttons and a tip that feels a little bit fragile. This is the Lenovo Active Pen 1. It's got pinpoint accuracy with 2048 levels of pressure sensitivity to provide natural pen and paper experience when you sketch on the screen. The two side buttons can be configured to open any favorite app quickly. Now let's test this baby. As my pen approaches the screen, just 1 centimeter before it touches the screen, a pointer appears. Without any calibration, it is rather accurate. Of course, don't use it at an angle. On a browser, the pen behaves like a finger for scrolling up and down. But unlike the finger, it can't do left and right swipe. Tap the keyboard or write instead of type. Inside Internet Explorer, you can add written notes. Draw a circle, write something. The screen is a little bit wobbly, so I'm going to change it into the tent mode. If I use a little bit of pressure, I get a thin line. When I press harder, I get a thicker line. Thin. Press harder. Release some pressure. Get a thinner line. Or I can start with lots of pressure and slowly release the pen. It gets thinner and thinner. And of course, you determine your own maximum thickness. Now let's try the pen with Windows Ink Workspace. Let's draw a line and do some shading, add some highlights. As you can see, I'm not a professional artist. One thing the pen can't do is drag and drop my events on the Google Calendar, which means it can't highlight text too. If I want to highlight some text, I have to use it like I'm using my finger. Press and hold, and then drag the markers
which is not practical.
The pen is supposed to act like a mouse pointer. If I'm using my finger and I want to do a drag and drop or copy and paste, in a normal mode, I would use the trackpad. But in a tent mode, my trackpad is on the other side, and I can only rely on my pen as the mouse pointer, but it's not working as a mouse pointer. This review seems to be on the negative side. Maybe because I don't know how to use this pen. If you know, please leave them in the comment section below. Tell me how to set this pen, make it work like a mouse cursor pointer or a mouse pointer. Without that, this is totally useless.
A few more questions from Ren Shamtov. If only the tip of the pen touches the screen, will it draw on the screen? Or do you have to apply some pressure on it to work? Okay, Ren, here's my experiment. I'm just holding onto the pen like this without applying pressure. It's touching the screen now. And just let the gravity pull it down. However, if I apply a little bit of pressure, just a little bit, yes, and it starts drawing.
I hope that answers your question. And if you have any more tests you'd like me to test with this pen, let me know in the comments section. And if I find a solution on a better way to use this pen, I'll place it right here. In the meantime, like and subscribe and share. See ya.